Right, so I am moving directly into Retro Jam 7, which is Koohoo themed. Jungle temple texture set. This released in 2022, which is 5 years after the last one. Because the last one was 2017, this one's 2022, yeah. It's interesting, there's like a... Maybe people got like burned out on the Retro Jam stuff, I don't know. But this one's also notable because this is the only one that has a start map. And also has the unholy trifecta of having a map from Entsoy, Ish, and there's a solo release from, is it pronounced Cocerello? I don't know. So yeah, this could go either way, honestly, in terms of how I feel about it. Castle of Starthoo. Also, interestingly, no map from Skaki in this one. I feel like I've had a look at this start map before. Is there something hidden in the water? I don't know. That was like a while ago that I had a brief look at this start map because I was like curious about it. Yeah, I think there's a nightmare portal back there. So there's your nightmare portal. I'm not going in there. Especially with the host of mappers that are in this one. I'm good. Yeah, generally I like the Koohoo texture theme. I wanna like make a Koohoo map at some point. I'm just not sure of what yet. It's on my list of things to do eventually. Endbringer, oh boy. What a name. Right. I'm just having a second look around. I'm gonna remove a name from the list here. I wonder if he made the start map. Right, Chris Holden. Either that or he like ended up in there where he's not supposed to be. I don't know. What was the name of this one? Ambulatory Remix. Is that like a multiplayer map or something? Four enemies, six secrets. What is ambulatory? Okay, so I take it that it's supposed to be marked by that yellowish light color, except you also made, like, the torches the same color, so it just kind of doesn't stand out. It's a bit of an odd choice. So I need two keys, or potentially one key, and then I come back. Wow. I already have a nail gun, but thank you. Yeah, now I'm like curious, what is ambulatory? And what is ambulatory, and why is there a remix? I don't know. Googling didn't bring anything up. Okay. I was about to say, I could really use a double barrel about now, but I got it, so don't need to say that anymore. What's over here?
Thank you.
Okay, go use hello. What are you doing in there? This is a silver key. So it goes over here. Okay, what did that do? Oh, maybe it raised a bridge. Oh, I'll bet that's what it did. Weird that there was no message for it, though. Interesting. Even more interesting, you use like the floor texture for like leaves. Interesting choice on that one. Thank you. or does not have a sound on it. Alright. Brings me back here for some reason. Uh-huh. Oh, because I'm supposed to lower this and then pick this up. Got it. Okay, so I go this way now? Yeah, that's totally not suspicious at all. Somehow missed like 8 enemies. Are they like hiding in secrets or something? Yeah, that was fun. Right. Start map. Yes. Okay, so does it mark when the maps are done? That is a question. I had to like figure out where that map is first though. It does not. Okay. So yeah, just have that on standby. I don't know what Ambulatory is, and I don't know if the remix of Ambulatory is, I don't know what that's a remix of. But the Lost Koohoo Temple. Holy shit, dude just included his whole fucking name in that BSP. 37 enemies, 5 secrets. Okay. Interesting lighting there. No secret in the plat. All right. That's a very interesting brick texture. I don't think I've ever seen that anywhere. Huh. And then you got it like mashed up against that one. Okay. Also, the sky texture changes. I'm just gonna write that off as going into another dimension. That's what I'm going with. Isn't there a texture, like a door texture in the Koohoo thing that lets you make that centered? I swear there is. I have a feeling this is a first map, right? Gives off that kind of energy. Yeah, he uses one of the doors right there. Good secret.
Thank you.
Alright, I need to take this back over here to the weird key door. Somehow that is not at all how I expected that to open. Okay. You know, I probably should have double checked to make sure there's not like any weird dependencies with this one. Because, if I remember, this was the year that almost, like, a lot of stuff ended up using copper. Okay, no, it is vanilla. Just wanted to make sure. Quad. I mean, like, layout-wise, that was fine. There's some definite weird texture choices. Like I said, there was the, there was that two skyboxes thing that I don't think quite made sense, but it was fine. Right, next one is Entsoy. I have to, like, find it because everything looks like roughly the same. The only thing that's like different here is that. I mean, unless they go in, do they go in alphabetical that way? Seems like they might. Okay. Endbringer. 55 enemies and 0 secrets. Okay. Is this actually going to be like a regular map? I don't know why I'm looking for secrets. It says there's literally no secrets in this level.
Thank you.
I mean, it is, like, dark, which, you know, I was kind of expecting that, but it's not, like, I would say oppressively dark, like some of his more recent stuff. This is, like, an acceptable level of dark. So that gave me a grenade launcher. And I have a silver key. Okay, I go this way. Where it starts. I mean, again, though, this is like actually kind of reasonable. Where'd all the zombies go? Wait. All the zombies are just gone? So where did the zombies go? Because I'm pretty sure that's the remaining kill count. Did they, like, get teleported somewhere? The fuck? Weird. Because, yeah, I killed the Vors and they just, like, disappeared somehow. I don't know. But yeah, so far I think that's been my favorite Entsoy map that I've ever played. I actually had fun with that one. Yeah, I'm just gonna keep going. Might as well just do this whole thing. Alright, next one is Greenwood. ...132 enemies and 7 secrets. Oh boy. Also, I think this is the first time I've ever seen anybody use this water texture. I think I've seen this in like a texture wad somewhere and I thought that it looked weird. This is the first time I'm actually seeing it used. Oh, it's slime! Even better. I thought that was water. It was, in fact, slime. And it don't look like slime. Thank you. Something got telefragged. Seven secrets on this level, huh? Gold key for something. Gold key for those, all right. So I open that gold key door and then... Where would I go from there? Oh, this way? Huh. That's neat. Given this grenade launcher, but like half of the enemies are placed in areas where I just can't really use it. This new? I think this is new. Isn't that a button texture? Isn't that a light texture? Weird. Somehow that wasn't a secret. Okay. Oh, does this have like respawning ammo in it? Because I think I picked that up already. Mm. Yeah, that's just fucking mean. Didn't find a single secret in that level. Oh god, I'm not looking forward to what's coming up next. My experience with Ish maps thus far has been extremely hit and miss. I don't really trust them with the Koohoo theme, let's just get this over with. Starting with an axe, okay, okay. So what I'm gathering from this is you want me to swim in that toxic sludge pit there. We're off to a great fucking start. I'm good. No, fuck that. I'm good. That, I don't want to be here. Sorry, I'm just going back to the start. No, that is enough to piss me off. I'm good. I don't even want to. I don't have the patience for that shit. I might come back to it later, but I'm probably not going to if that's the way that level's gonna start. Just doesn't seem worth it. Huh. 116 enemies, 4 secrets. Thank you. Oh, those are solid. Okay. This one looks pretty cool. I like that ceiling texture. Is it a button? It is not a button. So there are three of those, all right. Seems really rude, but whatever. Oh. Let's like try this again? I don't know, man. What was the point in coming in here? Was there a point? Oh, it opened that. Now that just leaves the spike hallway. Hey, fucking Jesus, dude. Around to see if I can find something that can potentially help me. You got anything here? No? I mean, armor would be appreciated. Don't really think I needed the health pack so much as an armor, but hey. Mm. I mean, any armor at all really would do. I just need something to mitigate the damage from the spikes. Because otherwise I'm going to die there like 100 times, and I really don't want to do that. Those kind of runes are like my mortal enemy, and I despise them with a passion. I'm looking for. So there's nothing. Just nothing at all, huh? Really? Huh? I mean, I don't have the health to do that now, so... I don't think I'm gonna have the health to be able to do this, and I don't have any armor, so I'm gonna mark this one as a dud as well. I'm skipping that one too, because I don't think I can complete that one. I'm really bad at rooms like this, so this is partly on me, but yeah, I can't do that. It's like right at the end too, pretty sure. It's really disappointing. This looks nice. A lot of explosive boxes around. Interesting. Yeah, I'm leaving that quad there because something tells me I'm gonna need that. Thank you. So, okay, I was about to ask, is there gonna be, like, any other weapons? Because I'm getting kind of tired of single shotgunning Death Knights. Okay, where am I supposed to be going? There's like... I'm like... lost, the fuck? Oh, do I have to like jump across these boxes? Is that what's going on here? Okay, first key, progress. Oh. Actually anything up here though other than like the cells, so oh, there's a rocket launcher. That's probably my favorite map so far. I don't know why that put me here, but all right. So I apparently have all my weapons. Interesting. Confirmation for the Underworld. 113 enemies, 2 secrets. Okay. Why did I keep... Okay. That's... I don't think I'm supposed to have all this. I don't know why I have all that stuff. It seems weird. Start that again. There we go. Oh, okay. I'm just gonna start running past things. Another double barrel. I guess we're just skipping the nail gun and going straight for the super. Thank you. can jump over there, can't I? So this begs a question, though. Can I skip that by going over here? That looks reachable, right? I'm sure somebody better than me can probably reach that. Most fun. I just think that beginning where I kind of had to run past everything was a bit off, but the rest of that was quite good. Going this way. Lost in time. I mean, off the bat, I'm not quite getting the Mayan vibe of Koohoo. I'm getting more of an Egyptian vibe, but we'll see where this goes. I mean, okay. Maybe they're going for that, id one, like, Mayan temple vibe. I think there was like a bit of that in, well, it wasn't id 1, it was one of the mission packs, I think, had that. Probably Dissolution? Huh? Well, you know, I'm very, I am a little bit disappointed that you didn't just drop that platform, like, straight into the lava. I feel like that would have been a good opportunity to do that. I don't usually condone, like, dickish traps, but I think that would have been a good opportunity to do that. That one was really short, but it was fun. That's all I have to say about that one, really. There's really not much to say about it. Last one. Ancient Trenches of Vellamo. 227 enemies and 9 secrets. Oh boy. Speaking of mission packs, isn't this one of the mission pack songs? I feel like no one ever uses those. Outside of like maybe Shades, I think Shades has used them a few times. Oh no, maybe it's not? Oh no, it is. Yeah, okay. Levels, huh? Great. entirely sure what the point of the ring is at this point. Other than, like, hitting these two, maybe? But, like... Don't hit these buttons because apparently it just summons an angry horde of knights rather than, you know, being able to like sneak past the knights. If this were timed right, you just can't even do that. I have a sneaking suspicion if I jump on that, it would open that door. Just a hunch.
Huh.
Hey, and I don't really know what I... Oh, there we go. Mm-hmm. Am I missing something with that, or what's going all the way back here? Is that that's where my save is? Okay. That's like 10 minutes back. this. Go back down, and then what? Gonna be honest, this is probably my least favorite water section I played, and somehow I'm putting that above Abyss of the Troglodytes. I don't like this, I think this is kind of tedious.
Thank you.
suddenly this just went from being somewhat fun to just kind of being annoying. This is just... the fuck, dude? I want to have, like, a second apiece, like... but there's just fucking enemies everywhere in here. So was I supposed to pick up a Thunderbolt at some point? Because I did get a Thunderbolt. When did I get a... Right, I got a Thunderbolt in there. There's so much shit going on, I'm just immediately forgetting everything. I don't want to do any of that again. Stuck on something. The fuck was that? I'm going to guess that a good chunk of the missing kill count is probably fish. Yeah, I'm not going back to do Ish's map. I'm good. I'm not going back to retry that one. I don't think it's worth the headache. But, I mean, this one was, like, mostly good. I do still have to play Cocerello's map, but... is it my favorite one? No, I still think that goes to the vertical runic one. Jam 3, I think that was. Yeah, I still think that one was my favorite. But I'm gonna end with this one. So yeah, this one was a solo release set. I didn't, I guess it didn't like make the deadline or something. What was that? 23 hours turtle map. See that nail gun there? Interesting. Oh. I mean, I like the cave section, it's kind of nice. Looks like watery bits are kind of interesting, too. Crystals kind of give me like vibes of that one Necros map that I played. Altar of Storms, I think it was, the one that's supposed to look like an alien ruin. That's what it kind of reminds me of. I dig it. Huh. Right, and this key goes somewhere. Here. Okay. A very weird like couch. It's like all made of wood. It can't be very comfortable. I guess that would make it more of a bench than like a couch though, right? Having a bit of trouble there, my guy. Hey, how you doing? There you go. I don't know what the fish are doing. It's a bit weird. Alright, where am I going with this key? All right, back here. Yeah. I need another one. Okay. Oh yeah, you can't have more than one key at a time in vanilla, so I have to come back and get this. That's fun. Okay, so let me just use this first. Give him credit for what was that? Said like a 23-hour something or another. It's pretty impressive. This ambush is kind of fucked. Oh yeah, how many days are on the that current jam they're running? Oh, they took the timer down from slips here. Interesting. I don't know why. That was actually kind of a decent feature. Days. So many fish in this level. I mean, that kind of explains why the kill count is like 153, Seems like a good chunk of them are just fish. It's like 4:30 here. I'm probably gonna go to sleep after this. Supposed to be. I figure that's supposed to be like a sink. Weird. Yeah, so there must have been like a... Oh my god, there's 11 secrets on this level? So I'm guessing there's a thunderbolt hidden somewhere. Neat. The exit? It is. I mean, I think out of all the... I want to say it's pronounced Cocerello. I don't know. I think I butchered it in the past. Honestly, that's probably my favorite map of his. Yeah, so this jam is like really weird. I skipped out on two maps. One of them probably because I skipped out on the end of Iago's because I think I fucked up and I couldn't actually complete a room. It was the one with the spikes and the death knights that just I don't think I had enough health to deal with that. And then I skipped Ish's because, well, you know. I think the surprise one, though, is like Entsoy's map was actually pretty good in this one. And I'm not entirely sure why that was. Yeah, I don't know. I didn't even get that far into Ish's map. I got to the spike trap, and I'm like, yeah, no, I'm done. I don't have the patience for it. That was like my tipping point was literally like 3 minutes in. So I think that's like a record for Ish maps. So yeah, there was 2, 3, 4. There was like 10 maps in the original jam, 11 if you count Cocerello's, and I mean, yeah, this wasn't like bad. I still think my favorite jam out of the retro jams was the vertical runic one. I just think that one was like really quality compared to the other ones. I don't know. But yeah, I It's gonna be like really fun because Quidicta doesn't have like an actual system for rating things anymore, so I can't actually keep track of what I played and what I haven't. But But yeah, so I think my favorite map out of this, if we're not counting Cocerello's, because that was a solo release, so I mean, 23 hours is still really impressive for that one. It was probably this one. Yeah, I think this was probably my favorite map. And then I think the runner-up is probably either Ricky T's or Chris Holden's. I mean, on the upside, I do have like the stream archive. So if I really wanted to keep tabs, I could use that. But yeah, this map, like, I'm actually gonna get a screenshot right now. Gonna use that later. Yeah, I mean, this wasn't like bad. I still prefer this one over the like wind tunnel one. So it's got that going for it. Yeah, I don't know what to do now. I guess I'd go back to what I was doing before I started this, which was... Oh yeah, I never played the oral map series. I never actually went through with that. But yeah, I should probably go to sleep. I think I'm going to hold off until the, well, no, because the remix jam is like 5 days until its deadline. I don't plan to make anything for that. I think that whole thing is like remix a multiplayer map for single player, and I don't really, I mean, it's like a really loose, like, prompt, but at the same time, I don't know what I would make. I did have one idea, but I don't know if I can actually make that work in time. But, yeah, I might be back tomorrow or the day after, but I'm probably, I've been, like, grinding in a Pokemon MMO. I'm probably gonna go back to that for a bit. Oh, are they using copper? That's fun. Are they using... I'm guessing they're using new copper, though, so... I mean... I say this like I actually play on Nightmare. I don't think it matters for me, but... yeah. Oh, yeah, I guess I could go through the rest of the Kona maps that I never actually... Because I, like, started going through the Kona maps, and then I just never finished that one. So I might end up doing that. Because so far I've enjoyed most of the Kona maps that I played. I think there was, like, one that I didn't like, but I don't remember which one that was. So yeah, I might do that in, like, a... couple of days or so, but I'm going to leave. When I come back, I'm going to probably go back to PokeMMO grinding for a bit, because I keep trying to shiny hunt, in Challenger's Cave, and I swear that cave is fucking cursed. Because I haven't been able to find anything in like 3 years, and it's really starting to get on my nerves. My theory is maybe January will be a lucky month and I can find something. I don't know. But yeah, I'm gonna go for now. Maybe be back tomorrow or the day after to do that. Good night.